Hello, in this video we'll see how to create a multi-story building with a grid of windows on the facades. And we'll use the Visualar Grasshopper components for that. So first of all, I will launch Grasshopper. We can see we have here all the Visualar objects available from Grasshopper, the Visualar components. And we'll start by defining the boundary of my building. So we can use a rectangle, so we go to Curve, Primitive, Rectangle. And there we go. We will just do right click here to extract the parameter so we can hide this plane. We'll define the width and depth of this rectangle with a number slider. Okay, I do right click here to edit the values so they can go from, let's say, 5 meters to 25. Okay, so I plug this in here, I copy and paste this slider for the Y dimension. And now, we can create four walls out of this rectangle using the Visualar Wall component. That requires a path curve, so we'll plug the rectangle. Now, these walls are created with a standard parameter, so I'm using a kind of standard style here with three layers. If I want to change that, I need to put a wall options component in there. So we'll just plug the wall options, and here I have the height, the style, or the alignment of that wall. So for example, we can go here to params, architectural inputs, and we can change the wall alignment into left, for example. Okay. More. We have here the list of object styles, architectural styles, so if we won't need to change the wall style of those walls, we do right click on this component, set one wall style, and this selects one of the existing styles we have in the document. So let's say for example the generic 300 in this case. We'll plug it in here and they get that style. We can also set the height, so again we place a numeric value here, we do right click to edit the values, so we can see this will get a maximum of 5 meters and a minimum of 2 meters. Say OK, and this defines the height of those walls, or what is the same, the floor height. Okay, now if I want to place windows in these walls, I need, first of all, to use the window command, the window component. So these windows requires a host, which is an optional thing, but they really need a position. So the position could be some divisions that I add to the segments of this rectangle. So what I would do is run the find the division command under curve, division, divide curve. So the curve to divide would be the rectangle. But this is taking the whole rectangle as one curve. I want to explode this rectangle into different segments in order that I divide each segment into a number of points. So we'll get the explode component that I've got here. I connect here the rectangle, and for each segment I connect to the curve, so I get all the divisions into the different segments. So I can add here a numeric value to determine the number of divisions. So first I will set this as an integer, and the values will go from 1 to, let's say, 10 for example. Okay, I will connect this into the count input and just call this window count. Okay. All right, take into account that this is defining the number of divisions, but not the number of windows that I have in the middle. So I will just add one value here, one item. So I go to maths. Plus, I will set here number 1. So instead of 4, I get 5. And what I get here, 4, corresponds to the number of windows that have in the middle part of the of each wall. Okay. Now, actually, these points are also taking the first and the last point. So I need to cool these points in order that they are not used to place the windows. Actually, we can already test. If we connect those points to the position of the windows, we can already see that the windows are also created in the corners, which is something that we don't want. Okay. Just for playing, we will just put the window count to a smaller value, let's say 2. So it will be easier to work at the beginning. Now, we need to cool the first and last point for each segment, and we will do that with a cool component that we can find in here. So we have sets, sequence, and cool index. All right, so the list will be the list of points, and the indexes will be 0 on one hand. So let's here use a panel to type the number 0. Okay, we can use another panel to see the group, the point, the group of points that we are having here. So basically, we need to cool for each group of points, for each segment, we need to cool the index number 0 and index number 3. And this number 3 is given by the number of components we have, number of points we have, which are basically this value plus that one we have here. So it's basically this result value that we have here. So we will hit shift to connect this in the indexes. So the indices 0 and 3 in this case are called from this list. So instead of these points, we will now connect these points. Okay. Now, all these windows don't have host. That's why in some cases they don't find the corresponding orientation. So in order to orient them accordingly, we need to connect them the right wall. Okay. So we have the walls in here. We could connect this directly and see what happens. So basically, we have here some groups of points, but we have a list of walls. So we need to graph that those walls in order that each one gets a group of points. So we'll do right click on this output and say graph. Okay, and this makes that the windows are created for each group of 2 points in this case. Okay, what we will do next is creating the building and levels of this model. So here under the Visual Arc ribbon, we have the building and levels. So we can place here one building and one level component to generate the building and levels of that model. So I will just use a panel to give a name for the building. Let's call this my building. So we'll connect this in here, and we'll connect these levels to the levels of the building. But there is still some information missing, which is the name and elevations of these levels. So the name of the level will be a combination of a string and a series of numbers. So for doing that, we need a concatenate component that we can find here under sets, text, concatenate. And combination will be a string. Let's call this label and give a space to add a number later on. And some values that can go from 0 to any number according to the number of floors we want. Okay, so we'll just place here a new number slider. We'll say this is they are integers, and we edit it in order to say okay, minimum 1 and maximum, let's say 20 floors. Okay, this will be called number of floors. Now I need to create a series of numbers, so I'll go to sets, sequence series. The start will be 0, the step count will be the floor height, sorry, will be 1, and count will be the number of floors. Okay, that gives me list of numbers, okay, that I can convert them into integers with this integer component. And now I can plug these integers into the fragment B in order to get as a result combination of levels, string, and the number of floors. Okay, so this will go to the names of my levels. Okay, and now I need to place the same number of elevations as floors I have in that model. So the elevation will be also a series of values. So again, go to sets, series, and the step count in this case would be the floor height that we have used before for the wall height. Okay, and the count will be the number of floors. So this gives me as a result a series of elevation that I can plug into the elevations of the level. So once I bake this component, the buildings, I take a look at the levels of that model and I can see all number of the number of levels with the corresponding elevation. Now let's copy these walls and these windows up in order to get the other floors. So all I need to do is to add a move component. We go to transform, Euclidean, move, and we'll need to move. We can start with the windows or we can start with the walls. So we'll move them up. So I need a vector, unit set vector, and here the step count will be the same as I used for the elevations. Okay, so I can actually take these elevations that I connected here for my levels into the Z vector for moving these walls up. Okay, we can check that if we change the number of floors, this goes up. Right, now we need to do the same for the windows. So I can just copy and paste this this component, and here we'll connect the windows instead of the walls. But I can see that not all windows are copied. Again, I just need to graph these windows in order that they are grouped in a way that each window individually is moved vertically to the corresponding elevation. So we are ending up with a definition that just changing the window count or changing the number of floors it generates a multi-story building with a grid of windows on the facade. Just for finishing, we can add here the slabs for each floor. So basically, I can move the same. I can use the same workflow for making copies of the original rectangle up. So we just copy and paste this component. And here I will just connect the rectangle, the original rectangle I had in my definition. Okay, if I select this and make a preview, I can see all the rectangles copied up. Now, I can insert here a slab component, connect it here. I can see that there is an error here. So what we will do to make sure that this works is exploding these rectangles. Okay, again with a curve, explode. And we will join all the same eggs again, which will ensure that resulting curves are valid for generating the slabs. Okay, now when I select these objects, I bake them, and they become bigelar objects in the model. If the intersection is not solved automatically, you can just select these objects, run the update command, and the intersection will be calculated. Okay, we can add finally here a section line to see how this building looks like in section. Let's call this section A, and from the section manager activate the section and see how everything looks like.